12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And on this week's show.
Very exciting show this week.
Well, thank goodness for that after last week.
I know, last week Sam's Mind special didn't work out too well, but we've got some really cool stuff. We've got a special guest.
Yeah.
Special guest in the audience. And also, as well as the special guest, we have, opening the show, an oil and water.
This is what you were looking at.
Yeah.
Right,
Oil and water. Not just any oil and water. Oil over troubled water by Kim Wist and Christian Engblom.
Okay, yeah, the inventor of the cooler.
Exactly. Yep. And anybody who's seen the Wizard Product Review knows that Dave isn't the most... You're not the biggest fan of oil and water.
I like David Regal's routine, because he gets the energy into it, but that's because David's a good performer. He can
take something quite basic
and make it entertaining. He's got some Giovanni in him.
I think we need to do that. You know, we need to start coming up with the phrase, Giovanni it up.
Yeah, getting some Giovanni into it. Yeah, can you do that with this?
Well, I can. I mean, this is an awesome oil and water. Get a couple of quotes here. This trick is as close to perfection as you can get, and it will literally fool everyone.
Well, that's a bold statement, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's going to fool everybody.
Yeah,
that's the ad copy. So if it doesn't fool me now, do you get your money back?
No, that's not the ad copy. That's a quote by Roberto Gobbi.
What does he know? Crikey.
Well, he wrote
a few books.
Yeah.
That's all he knows, yeah.
And get this, the most diabolical oil and water ever conceived. This is a show-stopping...
Ever conceived.
This is a show-stopping performance piece suitable for both TV appearances and extreme close-up.
What's extreme close-up?
Extreme close-up.
What is extreme close-up?
It's close-up magic.
That's while you're snowboarding.
While you're snowboarding or something like that, yeah.
It's close-up.
Hang gliding. Do that free-flying. They drop out their helicopter and they're doing stand-up Monty on each other on the way down. Hold on to your card.
I've got
the queen over here.
It's extreme close-up.
Anyway, I haven't got time for phase three.
It's extreme close-up. Look.
Land on the ground. Look, they're all queens.
No. Right, here's what it could be. You know, like that guy at the gig that goes, right, I'm going to watch really carefully now. I'm going to catch you. Imagine doing a gig.
They just sit back and go, wow, mate, you're real magic.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't get that.
Where they're trying to see secret moves and that. No. They just believe I'm real magic. Don't you get that?
I get it all the time. Imagine
really.
A room full of like 50 of them and that's extreme close-up.
Yeah, extreme. And they're all really close.
And they're all like this.
Are you up for that? Are you up for some extreme close-up?
I could do extreme close-up.
Some extreme close-ups.
I could do some extreme close-ups.
John, can we get it off the sticks?
Cool. So let's try this, Dave. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm going to put the deck down here. There's a little story about this pack of cards.
Really?
Yeah, there's a little story. I'm going to tell you about it right now. Basically, this trick came about out of necessity.
Right.
You see, I was booked to do a gig last week.
Yeah.
Okay. And I was on the way to the gig, and I was late.
You were late?
I was late to the gig. I know.
Disgraceful. I've never been late.
You've never been late. I was late. And it get worse, to be honest, because not only when I was late, but when I got there, I realised I'd pretty much forgotten all my props.
It's pretty bad.
I was late.
Yeah.
And I had no props. The audience...
It's not very professional, is it, Craig?
No, it's okay.
You weren't dressed for your gig.
Yeah.
I forgot my suit. Still had my coat on.
Yeah.
And the audience were pretty hostile. They were a bit annoyed that I was late.
Yeah, it was extreme close-up, wasn't it?
Well, it was extreme close-up, yeah. I mean, there were really extreme... There's a wind machine in the corner that set up as well. And
what did you do?
Well, I only had one pack of cards. I managed to grab a pack of cards that I had in
the
car.
That's all right, yeah.
The only trouble with that is it was my discard pack. You know, like when you do a gig and you've got a few cards left at the end of the night?
Yeah.
And you kind of put them away because you think, I'll have a use to them. I've got like tons of cards
like this.
Yeah,
piles of old bike
boxes. Exactly. Yeah. Well, I grabbed one of them from out of the car, which, you know, is a bit of a problem because, I mean, what are you going to do with that?
Oh, Craig.
What are you going to do with
that? What did you do? Did you book somebody else?
No, I didn't. I was there. I didn't have time to book anyone else.
They were all mixed up.
I, you know what I did? I improvised.
No.
If you're in a situation like this, no props.
You do psychic touching.
Do
psychic touching.
No, I didn't.
You don't need any props.
I didn't oil and water.
What?
Come on, that's what you'd think of as well, isn't it?
No.
I didn't oil and water. Yeah, let me show you. Look.
Go on.
I'm going to use... What?
Sorry.
What?
Here we go again.
Look, just keep your fingers crossed that this is going to work
out.
Yeah, okay,
right.
We got three. We're going to use six cards altogether, three blue and three
red. Are they going to represent oil and water?
Not in my pattern, no, but you could have them represent oil and water if you wanted to. But three red cards, three blue cards. The rest of the cards, they're not important.
Okay.
The only important ones are these. Now, John, it's important that you realise where to look, being the cameraman. You want to be looking, it's not about the backs, it's about the fronts. It's actually about the back. Most tricks are about the front. I'm concentrating so much.
Cock up senses tingling.
It's going to work. It's going to work, okay?
I hope it does for the sixth time.
So we've got the red cards and we've got the blue cards, okay?
Yeah.
Red cards and blue cards, right.
I have got a show New Year's Eve. I'm just telling you that.
Watch. I got this sorted. Red cards and blue cards, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to put down a blue card.
Yeah.
And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a red card and I'm going to put a red card on
top.
Then I'm going to put a blue card.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to put a red card.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to put a blue card. Then I'm going to put a red card. So basically,
that's
they're intermixed. Red, blue, red, blue, red,
intermixed.
Blue. Intermixed.
Intermixed,
yes.
Intermixed.
Intermingled, intermixed. It's a new word.
Right.
All I have to do is do the magic gesture.
He says crossing, doing the sign of the cross.
A snap.
Isn't on camera. So.
And then hopefully with any luck.
Ooh.
Yeah, baby.
Ooh,
come
no,
on.
Not an Elmsley insight.
Not an Elmsley insight. Now I'm going to, I really should quit while I'm ahead, but I'm going to do it again.
No,
okay? Yeah, I'm going to do it again. But this time, I'm going to do it slower than you've ever seen.
You can't make it slower.
Literally, watch this. You couldn't make it slower. Red card. Yeah, we really should have some sort of music, shouldn't we? A red card. A blue card. Yeah? Red card. A blue card. A red card. That's helping. And a blue card.
Yeah.
Now, let me just show you the situation.
No, don't do that.
I really want to. They're all mixed up.
Yes, they are! All mixed up. Woo!
Red, blue, red, blue, red, red. This is incredibly exciting.
For us at this point, as we get 2 minutes into this bloody trick.
Right, what I want you to do, look, let's just hope this works now. What I want you to do is pinch the end. It's all going to happen in your hands.
No.
You might feel a little bit of heat right now.
I can.
And it's done. No, it's not. Not yet. Hang on.
Oh, come
no, hang
on,
hang on. Yeah, yeah, hang on.
Let me try. Bloody illusion.
Oh, thank you. Look at that.
Ooh.
In your hands. They separate into red and blue.
Yeah.
Of course, that's where most magicians stop. But I'm going to go further than that,
no.
Dave. I am. You remember the deck that was all mixed up?
Yes.
Do your little wavy thing one more time.
Yeah. And don't forget, make the oil and water separate.
Yeah, and look at that. Every single card in the pack separates out all the reds and all the blues. And that's what I did to blow that audience away.
Whoa, did you take six times to do it, though?
No, I did it once.
No, you did it once and you remembered it.
It's actually a very easy trick. There's very little sleight of hand to it.
Stay tuned for the outtakes. That's all I can say.
The problem is I had like 25 minutes to remember the sequence. It's a little bit like stand-up Monty. There's a lot of sequence.
I know what you mean.
It.
Yeah, stand-up Monty. I was like, oh, what have I done there? And you have to go back to the start.
It's a little bit like that. You know, you've got a lot of sequence to it that you've got to remember, but the moves are actually very easy. It's just like stand-up Monty. The DVD, it's very weird, actually. You've got two performances, one by Kim Wist and one by Christian Engblom, and you've got two explanations, one by Kim, one by Christian. They're in both explanations, but they've got different handlings and different ways of performing it. I did Kim's.
Yeah.
Christian's got a different way of doing it.
You get the deck with it, obviously. The deck is gimmick to the hilt. You can't use it for anything else.
You cannot use it for anything else, but the presentation for it... It justifies not being able to use it for anything else. Because
come on, don't be a hypocrite.
What?
You've been on the Wizard product review so many times and go, we've actually heard him, haven't we, John? I don't want to carry another deck around just for this.
Yeah, no.
The trouble is, you get excited about one trick because it's oil and water and you become a total hypocrite.
No, what
you said, I think it was 4 weeks ago, you said, I don't want to be carrying another deck around just for, didn't he?
No, I agree. I'm going to find
that bit of footage.
No, I agree. But what I'm trying to point out, we're on different points here. What I'm trying to say is, you
know,
it's
like, oil and water, so the rules change.
You know, you see those magicians, and what they do is they stack up like four packs of cards, and they go, yeah, right, I'm going to do a trick with this one, now a trick with this one, now a trick with this one. Yeah. This has got a reason to come out as a trick in a deck in its own right.
Oh, right,
because
okay,
they're mixed up. I'm not saying it's okay to carry multiple decks around. I'm saying this has got a built-in
presentation.
All right, what I meant is this has got, let me clarify, this has got a built-in presentation as to why you should have this pack of cards and
right,
not be able
okay
to use the pack you've been using up until this point.
All right, I'll give you that one.
Yeah? Having said that, yes, I do hate carrying more than one pack of cards around with me because where am I going to put...
Well, in a parlor show, it is different.
Where am I, yeah.
Because you might have your briefcase on the side or something like that. I don't know anybody that does a parlor show completely from their pockets because
no,
you normally need a few bigger things and that kind of thing.
And I think this would play quite well in a parlor show.
Yeah.
I don't think it would work too well mix and mingle or table hopping or stuff.
Not a chance,
just
no,
because I think
you need
it would
to
work.
See and...
Yeah, but the problem with it is you cannot examine anything.
I think
this,
you need their attention as well before you start this kind of routine.
And you need to establish credibility. I think they need to realise that you're good before you go into something like this.
Yeah, absolutely. Don't just turn up at the gig, forget everything and do this.
No, because that just would be so...
You wouldn't do that.
No, no.
How much are you going to give it? It's a difficult one.
It is a difficult one.
It is a very clean oil and water. If you want to do it, and you want to finish, it gives oil and water a finish as
you know
well.
Where I think this will go well? In a magic competition. I could see in your club competition, I could see a lot of guys doing this. It's got a really nice kicker ending. I could see this working really well. I don't think many people are going to be doing
that's
it.
That's not going to affect my marks. I never
that's
judge things.
My,
yeah.
No. I'm just saying, that should really tell you the type of trick it is. It really is a magic
competition. I think if you want to do that trick, then the deck is very well gimmicked.
Oh, it is.
It's a great routine. There's a reason for everything. There's a reason for all the stages.
And I think that section where it happens in your hands.
I think
really
it
nice
is shocking at the end when the deck completely sorts itself out as well. I think it's great. I'm not going to do it. I think I've got more hard-hitting items and even more gentler items that still have more of a hard-hitting outcome. Even versions of Out of This World, I think, are better than Oil and Water. Oil and Water and Out of This World, I put into the same category as each other in that I believe the audience have to be in the same mood to watch it.
Yeah, yeah.
If they were going to watch this and going to watch Out of This World, you need that audience at that point, that attention level, that kind of thing to watch out a version of Out of This World. I think Out of This World is always stronger than Oil and Water.
But you,
for
you,
me,
you find that point in the gig and you can make a reputation. For example, a couple of weeks ago, I was doing a gig and I was going around doing big tables, doing all my best stuff in all the really big stuff. I was in the bar afterwards and the booker came in with a couple of people and I was like, oh, let me show you one more thing. I did Oil and Water, just a classic Oil and Water.
Really?
Yeah, I did the...
Okay, yeah, I believe that a nice sort of snappy version of it, yeah, it's showing skill, but for me I prefer Out of This World to Oil and Water.
Sorry, did I say Oil and Water?
The simple
I
thing.
Meant the classic, I did the classic Out of This World, Paul Curry. That's what
oh
I
yeah
meant.
Absolutely.
Sorry. Yeah, I wonder why you said
hard,
really.
It's hard hitting, yeah, that's why I was confused. But yeah, I like it, but I'm never going to do it, but I think that's a great version of it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I think that's a great version of Oil and Water.
Guys,
I don't like it though, but I'll give it 77% because I appreciate...
I think somebody will make a reputation with this.
I appreciate all the teaching and I believe that somebody at the right kind of pipe and slippers moment of a night could actually kill with this.
I agree. I'm going to give it 82%. And here's a tip. If you want a really, really commercial Oil and Water that can be done anytime, anywhere, look up Oily Snobs by Simon Lovell. That's the version I use.
Tip. It's special guest time on the Wizard Product Review. This is a guy, he's had so many products out.
Yeah, yeah. I think he's Mr. Worker of the Week. He's the English version of Garrett Thomas.
I think he's going to his head, though, a little bit. He's come in with those mirrored sunglasses today.
I know,
didn't he?
Yeah, and he
sat
down.
Walking around
like,
on his head and that kind of thing. He's going to his head a bit.
I think it might be a little bit. He's brought out some amazing products. He's brought out... what's he brought out? Look No Sharp.
No Sharp. I love that. I did that on the Wizard Product Review.
Yeah, yeah.
Not so sharp.
Yeah, the bonk thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The bonk thing.
Total ambition.
Total ambition. The sticker coming to the top of the deck with the initials on. And a trick I fooled you with.
Absolutely.
God, this was a long time ago. Knockout prediction.
It's awesome.
Fooled you with that badly. I used to fool a lot of magicians with that. And I've forgotten that I used to do it. So I need to dig that one out again, actually.
It's a great trick. It's awesome.
One of those tricks. Our very special guest. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Wayne Fox.
Come on!
What does the fox say?
I won't tell you what he says because everyone keeps on telling me about that.
Yeah, stop messaging him on Facebook. He's sick of it.
Just leave it out, all right? Okay. How you doing, Dave?
How you doing? Good to see you.
Good to see you, mate. Good to see you.
Good to see you. Blamo?
So, yeah, he's around there, but mate. There we go. So, first of all, how are we going to kind of cover this? This is your brand new product. It's called the Fox Holdout. Yep.
And there's been a lot of buzz. I know you put on your Facebook page a couple of weeks ago when we were going to review Vapor.
Yeah.
You put on your Facebook page, oh, I've got very excited on the show this week. We've got something absolutely amazing that's so much buzz about. And everyone just came on and said, what, the Fox Holdout?
Yeah.
It just people
actually,
assuming...
people comment. That's on my Facebook. Yeah, people
there's a lot of people
there.
That want to know about this product and are very excited about finding out more.
Okay.
I got to see it. When we were working
when
together,
Devon,
yeah.
didn't we?
You came back from that weekend. We were filming on the Monday,
yeah,
and you were
and
talking
I said,
about
you've
that straight
got
away.
To see this Holdout. Mm. It's absolutely
mainly
amazing.
Because Craig knows that I do a big coin production, and I was looking to kind of improve it or work more on this 3-inch coin production.
Yeah.
And Craig was telling me, you've got to see this because you do a big coin production,
jumbo
with
coin
it,
production
don't you?
With it. You can do a jumbo coin vanish with it as well, but I initially wanted something that I could use, that I could vanish and produce using everyday action. So it might be just to roll my sleeves up or something like that, and then I've switched something into play. That's what I wanted it for. But the initial idea of that isn't new. But the gimmicks that people were building at home, like we all do, don't we?
We all get
at home stitching things up. They just weren't...
And
cutting the mustard.
We're not going to show, obviously, we never show like gimmicks on the Wizard product review, but I can hold my hand up and say this is very, very nicely made. It's very,
very
comfortable to wear. And the great thing about it is it looks like nothing.
It looks like
nothing. You've got nothing.
And you can get into it and out of it anytime you want to. And your sleeves are rolled up. I perform with my sleeves rolled up all the time.
Yeah.
So for people that don't, you could go out and do this without a jacket.
Yeah,
you know, so if you wanted to have the same sort of feel in many ways as being able to do toppeting and so on and so forth, you can do that sort of stuff with your Holdout and a lot more just with a shirt with your sleeves rolled up.
So just going, what sort of things can you do with a Holdout? First of all, you can sort of get rid of a gimmick.
Yeah,
straight
you can
after.
Vanish, produce, and switch. So if I wanted to switch, basically some. A card I'm doing a tournament store and I need to ditch the pieces, I need to get rid of them quickly.
Yeah,
I wanted that to be hands-free, sleeves rolled up as I handed them the card back.
Because
you
can use it like to, overtly, or you could use it covertly, couldn't you? So you can use it that they don't know anything's changed. Because like you showed me the thing that you did with the Omni Pen earlier.
That's
great. We took some film of it where you were actually changing one object into another. There, it's kind of obvious that you've done some magic. You've done something.
Yeah.
But for me, I think the best use of it is when you're using it covertly and they're not even aware that anything magical has taken place.
Well, I'll tell
place.
You something. That one of my favourite things that you do with it is outside of the jumbo coin production, Wayne does an amazing bill switch where he's Brilliant. Not using a TT or anything like that. His hands are empty. He borrows a £10 note. His hands are empty. He folds it up. The entire way through, his hands are empty. Boom. Opens it up, it's a £50 note, hands it back, and his hands are empty and all the way through. And then he's in a situation where he takes it back and he can return it back into a £10 note. So imagine if you're doing Build to Impossible Location, you can vanish something, have it. It's just.
You could not just use it like a bill switch, you could very cleanly fold up a banknote and then. You know, flash it, burn it, sort of thing, and
we'll
end
it.
Up somewhere else in
exactly.
a completely impossible
and place. And your hands are empty the entire way through.
It's strange, you know, because a friend of mine, Sean Goodman, he wanted to do a... he does a lot of mind reading, that kind of stuff. Has made up an index, wants to bring up an index with it. So he's got his... He's still going through it as well, bless him. But it's basically, it's if there's pieces of paper... on there, you've written down something in the guise of reaching forward to pick it up, you've switched that piece of paper into play.
Wow.
So they've written something on there, so you can have something, I don't know, some, give me a number between 1 and 10. There's one piece of paper on there. When you open it up, it's got number 8 on it, or what they've said. It's going to be...
Great.
I wanted it very, very clean so that you could literally tug, there you go.
So it's obviously available. It's out now, the Fox Holdout. I know you lecture on it anyway. Craig said... by far he thinks one of the best things you do apart from the bill switch is the the Torn and Restored card. Mm-hmm. And we had a bit of a problem with Torn and Restored card last week, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
Twisted Queens with Sans Mines, where you just to run you through it, have you seen this trick?
I haven't. No.
It was a Torn and Restored card, so they tore up the Queen. Mm-hmm. It restored in the spectator's hands after some quite dodgy handling, but when they unfolded it, it was a completely different card with the Queen in a different position. And myself and Craig said on the Wizard product review, well, it kind of telegraphs what's gone on, right, if it's a completely different printed card at the end of it as well.
And they didn't even get it signed, you know, or anything like that. It was just weak on so many different levels.
Okay. Can you do your Torn and Restored card? Can we get it off the sticks?
Yes, I can.
John, can we get it off the sticks?
So this is the... the idea. I wanted it very free and open, so you just point to one. Great, it's up to you. Yeah. Is that okay? Yeah, and then write your name on it. Write something on there. I don't know. Bank details, PIN number, stuff like that. Never know. Don't ask, don't get. That's what Mum and Dad always says, isn't it?
Exactly.
Okay, and we've all. Dave.
That's fair.
Right, that's a signature.
That's fair.
Okay, cool. That's okay. The idea of this is I would like to keep that all the time with me.
Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
But obviously I'm not going to be able to do that. So you'd like to see it destroyed.
Yeah, that's very fair.
So that, well, kind of, I guess, yeah. It's,
no, that is very
you
bad.
Could, well, no, you could do. You could hold out your hand as well for me as well, so that this is... hold out your hand for me.
Yeah.
Very open and very fair, so you can catch the pieces as they fall. In one piece.
How cool is that?
It's so, so cool, yeah.
That's okay. Great. That looks great.
And I just wanted to end with that so that I could walk away.
And you're not going in your pocket for a lighter
or anything?
I've
not to go in there. I really wanted for a very, very long while just to do a Torn and Restored at my very fingertips. I was messing around with reels, shooting up my sleeve and all kinds of things. I wanted to do it very cleanly so that I could just tear, give them back the pieces, let them drop in their hand. Right. I love that moment as it drops in the hand. They're expecting it to, you know, especially if you choose a girl to do this all the time. They put their hands out like this, and as you drop them, it's always a big, they're going to catch lots of pieces, and it just drops down on their hand. And so as it drops in there. So, and that's what I wanted to do with it, you know. I wanted to come across with something that was going to, very clean. Very clean.
One of the things I'd say about this is Wayne's a working magician.
Yes.
You go out and you gig for a living.
Yeah.
And this holdout has been designed for the working magician in mind. You can keep your you can hold out your TTs.
Yeah.
You can hold out four coins. You can hold out jumbo coins. You can hold out gimmicks. You can have yourself set up with billet indexes. You can all.
I put my ITR on it as well.
Oh wow!
And I put an ITR on it so I can do all the
You got vanishes and ditches, and it's instantly reset. It's designed for people that go out there and work
and
with the sleeves rolled up in the trenches.
And it doesn't matter what size you are; it's completely adjustable as well.
I mean, if you're a kid, you know, you got really thin arms, or you got massive arms like mine. Feel that?
That's impressive.
I'm just saying.
You got some.
That is impressive.
Yeah, I'm just there with it. Right. So I noticed I went like that.
Yeah, at the same time.
and it will fit up to, you know, people who've got really big arms as well. So I wanted to make sure that it could fit neatly, but it was something you didn't have to walk away and stitch in.
Yeah,
you could just roll it up, throw it in your case, go home.
It's awesome,
you know. So
thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
And
I'm
showing it
Wizard
to us.
Product review. Look at me. I'm here. I didn't know I had the authority. Look at me.
We let anybody in these days. Oh. Thank you very much, Wayne Fox.
Thank you.
You're holding a blue back deck, and there's only one red back card in there. The spectator thinks of a card, never writes it down, never tells anybody, and never says it out loud. You turn over the red card, it's theirs. This is red. I'll tell you right now, down the bottom half of the deck, I've actually put a red card. Can you see that? What I want you to do now, I want you to spread the cards out towards you so you can see all of them, but don't let me or Freddie see any of the cards, okay?
Okay.
Have you got one?
Yes, can I show my friend?
If you want to, don't show me because okay. I don't want to know it. Yeah, okay.
Sure.
Square up the cards and give them a shuffle again. Mix them up for me, give them a really good shuffle. Brilliant. We'll put that away and we'll put the rest of the cards. Yeah. Now think about this. There is no way anyone could know what that card is. Because you had a choice of pictures and numbers, you went for numbers. You then spread through and you thought of any card.
Yeah.
And then you shuffle.
Yes.
No way, no one can know what the card is. Jane doesn't know, you haven't written it down, you haven't told Jane, you haven't told me. You've just thought of a card. You never wrote it down. You've never told anybody. The only person who knows that card is you. Is that fair to say?
Yeah.
And do you remember? I told you that there's a red card in here. I'm not going to say anything. Tell me when you see the red card.
No.
There. You see it, right? You've never said it out loud.
Hello.
And before you even did anything, that card's been there.
Yeah.
One card and one card only.
Yeah.
I don't even want to know the name of your card. I just want you to turn that over.
Ah!
What's the card?
The Two of Hearts.
The Two of Hearts. No way I could have known that. And that red card's been in this deck from the very, very beginning.
Yeah.
Turn it over.
I don't know. That's so good.
Told anybody. You've never wrote it down. That's the red card. For the first time, what was the name of the card?
Four of Diamonds.
Have a look.
Finally, this week, we've got Six by MIckael Chatelain.
No, Six 2.0. Because that's so 1990s, 2000. Six 2.0. It's
yes.
New and improved. MIckael Chatelain, the DVD, will teach you how to easily make the necessary gimmicks to present six routines included on
Hang
the
on.
DVD.
Gimmicks?
Yeah,
Michael.
Yeah, yeah. MIckael, yes, he's brought gimmicks out. It's very brilliant.
Are you serious?
It's a course in magic in the home, a lesson in creativity from the gimmick specialist.
Blue Peter crossed with magic DVD.
He really is. He's getting a name from it. And look, you get a little bag of bits.
It is good.
You got to love your little
bag of
bits.
Is that so you can do things with your dick?
Yes, your dick. Yes. It's so funny. Oh, MIckael. I can only say this because I'm friends with MIckael and, you know, I'd say this to his face, but...
Touch
oh,
my dick.
Mate. When you pronounce deck as dick, you don't want to go on stuff saying stuff like...
Shuffle my dick.
Now get the spectator to shuffle my dick and get the spectator to touch your dick. You can touch any dick you want to.
Just,
oh, man.
Work on it. Your English is a lot better than my French, but just that one bit. If you're going to do a lot of magic conventions,
yeah,
maybe change that. Now,
yeah, why don't you say pack instead?
Then right,
we're
yeah.
sorted. Then we're sorted. Then advice from me to you: start referring to it as a pack of cards, mate. So six routines, fully gimmick to the hilt. Bit of a mixed
well, no,
bag.
Yeah, I suppose they are. Right, should we talk about vision first of all?
Which for me is probably the standout trick on the DVD and one that you could have released as a single trick.
It could have been because it's a nice gimmick that you make
yeah.
up and
that's
you get all the bits to do that.
Imagine
but
this,
it
and it
gimmick.
Really is that clean. You've got a deck of cards which you're using throughout your set. It's a regular pack of cards. You have a card picked. You look away.
Yeah.
You show them their card. They can shuffle it into the pack.
They touch a card. You up jog it. You show it to them.
Yeah. You instantly know what it is. It's a way of glimpsing their card using a gimmick that you create that is incredibly easy to do. But it's basically you've created a gimmick into a joker. So at the end of the routine,
it's very covert.
You can take the jokers out and you're left with a regular deck of cards. It's very nice. It's ingenious. And I think it would fool magicians.
And I think CSI came out, didn't it? As a one-trick DVD. And I think this is a little bit better than that.
Yeah, I think this could easily be a one-trick DVD. I think this is that vision. version. If he'd released it as his own thing, I think people would have been very happy.
That's
as
worth
it is.
Saying.
Yeah. So now you've got In the Box, which was the card that appeared
in the Matchbox.
In the Matchbox. My problem with a card, it's not being a signed card. I've got notes on my phone. It's not a signed card. That's the main problem.
The thing is as well, it's not signed, but it's still a strong effect, even though it's not signed. You only have to look at like Inferno. I know it's a thought of card that ends up in the Matchbox. Hang on. I know you're
going
to
blow your argument out
the El Cheapo Magic Club. That's what you're going to say, aren't
you? I am.
Which is
I do that all the time.
Yeah, I have done it and need to go back to it because it is a very, very good routine of Michael Closer's.
When you start putting things in matchboxes, you're going to have to draw comparisons to the El Cheapo Magic Club. And I'm sorry, there is no routine out there that beats that. The presentation is brilliant. It allows you to give a business card out. It's an incredibly deceptive method. And it's a signed card.
But this is still a good trick.
It's still a good trick.
It's a good trick. A different concept in that you can kind of use it for something else if you wanted to. Because you're changing the whole thing.
It could be a prediction. It could be a very clean prediction, I suppose, yes.
Not using it this way. And it's not the best angle. Sometimes Michael does all these presentations just over his shoulder, and the misdirection doesn't work as naturally as it would do if you were in a live performance, when you were giving somebody the match to sign. And
no, I agree. It just left me a bit cold. Just it's not...
Unusual for something where you like matches.
That's very true.
Let's move on.
Moving on. The next one is the through
TikTok.
Box, the TikTok out the box, where you've got a TikTok box.
I quite like that.
Yeah, you've got a little orange one, you've got a little green one. He goes, name a TikTok, any TikTok, and he goes, bonk, and he pulls it out.
It does look good. Once again, you're seeing it in a very tight shot over your shoulder.
No, I thought that was good.
I think if you played that in a really nice situation, you know, and then you just took it out straight away, I think it's quite good.
What I didn't
very
like...
Very impromptu looking.
I did like that, but what I didn't like was his other Tic-Tac trick, which was a bonus.
It is a bonus
one
trick.
Where he's got this pack of Tic-Tacs, and they're full, and he shakes them, and he's like, yeah, this is full of Tic-Tacs, and he goes, watch, dodgy handling, and now they've all completely disappeared, and then brings them back, and you can't show them.
It's okay. I think I've seen something similar.
Please, Dave.
I think I've seen something similar years ago.
It's not okay. It's bad. No. It's very bad. It's very, very bad.
It is a bonus, though.
Then you've got, looking at my notes, Melt card, which was the shrinking card.
Yeah, it's okay. It looks good, but I'm never going to do it. But the effect is basically you've got a picture card, as it was in the description. Could be different in your box, but you've got a picture card up jogged, and you basically pass your hand over the top of it, and it becomes
visually,
a smaller
card. Visually,
it
looks really nice. Think about it. When you do an Erdnase change for a layman, they freak out.
Yeah.
That's... Imagine
so
what
I don't
the
need to do this then.
Imagine what the reaction would be. No, imagine what the reaction would be if you just took a card that they picked and you did this and it went really small and they examined
it. Well, that's the trick.
Yeah, exactly. I think it worked quite well. What I'm saying is I think it's a good trick.
It's all right?
I think it's all right, yeah. I think it's
you think that's better than the Tic Tac one?
I think the Tic Tac, vanishing Tic Tac thing was
no,
crap.
Coming through the box.
I know, I said I like that one.
All right, okay. I'm trying to find your trick of the DVD.
Oh, it's Vision.
Vision.
Enough said. Let's move on.
Okay.
Hearts was quite nice. He's got a pack of cards with a little heart drawn at the bottom of each one, and he gets somebody to pick a card.
You know what I'm going to say?
Yeah, if you're going to do something like that, One by Matthew Underhill is the winner.
I think One is probably one of the best tricks that World Magic Shop has ever brought out. And we were having this discussion, weren't we? Excluding our own material, of course. We never review our own products.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's one of the best tricks. I do it all the time.
Yeah.
And when you give that card, which is initialed, the hearts actually move. It's kind of like an impromptu version of that, but you've still got very similar gimmicks.
Yep.
So you may as well, for me, still do One.
Yep.
So... I liked it, but not as good as One. And if you're going to compare things like El Cheapo Magic Club and that kind of thing, if you've got to bring One into the equation when you're talking about hearts moving on a pack of cards.
I agree. It is a nice idea. It seems more impromptu.
The thing is with this, Steve, and we had this last week. Do you remember when we said at the end of the programme, you've got gravity still to talk about, but I want to bring this point up. We said at the end of the show last week, if you had all these tricks on one project, it would actually be quite good value.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. It is a very good valued product because I think there's a couple of things on here that you would do. I think your best trick is Vision. I prefer the one where the Tic-Tac comes through the box.
Okay, yeah.
I do like that effect. I think it's quite nice. In the right kind of context, I think you could really build that up.
Yeah, it
does look
impossible.
I think it's great value as a project. any one of these individually, I don't think will be that strong. But as a whole project, I think it's a great project.
So here's a question. I know what I think. Is it as strong as 6 version 1?
I don't think it's as strong as the first one. There's some good tricks on here, but it's not as strong.
No. Yeah. But it is good.
And there's a couple of bonuses as well as the 6 main tricks on there. I'm not going to give it as much as I did for the original 6.
By the way, just to be complete, gravity is, because you haven't talked about it.
Yeah.
Gravity is a thing where you've got 2 pencils, 2 packs of cards. You stand the 2 packs of cards up, you put the 2 pencils across, they name any pencil. When you pull the 1 pack of cards away, 1 pencil falls and the other ones remain suspended. A bit like a chair suspension, but without taking away the... But when you only take away the 1 chair, you don't take away the actual board. What I didn't like about it is the method for it is what I think most people would think.
They're going to think that's how it works.
Yeah, and that's how it does work. So you know, that's the problem with it. I think you'll get something out of it.
Yeah.
But I there's better stuff out there. There's worse stuff out there. There's better stuff out there by MIckael. But if you're a MIckael Chatelain fan, you're not going to be disappointed because, you know, there are some clever stuff. And Vision is brilliant. It really is. If you want a way to glimpse a card,
and I think the Tic Tac penetration is brilliant, and it would work very well in a better setting rather than just a static camera just over your shoulder. How much are you going to give it?
84%.
I'm not giving it that much. I'm giving it 81%.
Okay.
But I did like it, and I do think it's a great valued product. Mm-hmm. So once again, that's it this week for the Wizard product review. Thank you very much to our special guest, Mr. Wayne Fox Esquire, that joined us on the sofa this week. And we also had a look at oil over troubled water.
Yeah.
Which 6 takes later didn't turn out too bad. That's it this week for the Wizard product review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
See you next week.
Can't make it slower. And just so you can see, what the f***? What the f***? Hell, why is this happening? Sake, I've gone through it for
Shall we do take 5?